A while back, I released a video on the Medical Insiders channel about the science and the literature of whether stimulants like Adderall, Ritalin, etc. could help you get better grades in class. Now, I'm going to leave the science to that original video, but here, let's talk about more practical considerations. What's going on, guys? Now, in the world of self-development and optimization and study strategies, we focus very much on the tactics, what you should and shouldn't do, the specifics, the discrete steps, which is definitely valuable. I'm not arguing that. However, we often don't go a layer deeper to the mindset. And the mindset is also incredibly important. In fact, you could argue possibly more important because with the right mindset, you're more likely to have this domino effect of all these other behaviors that are more likely to lead to a certain outcome. Whereas with tactics, you may actually have only a fractional effect. Now let's talk about the mindset as it relates to stimulants and doing better in class. Now this video will not apply to you if you have a prescription from your physician for these medications. Now this is not medical advice. Do not start, stop, change, etc., any of your medications without first speaking to your physician. Now two big points that we'll first get out of the way. First, using these substances without a prescription is illegal and there are serious ramifications there. And second, some consider this to be cheating in the same way, you know, athletes using performance-enhancing drugs, which is a whole nother conversation. But anyways, that's more of a personal thing. I'm not gonna dive into that. Now, if you're ever wondering if I have done stimulants to improve my grades, the answer is no. Now, what was most disheartening when I created that first video was in the comments, a lot of viewers didn't believe that I've never done Adderall or Ritalin or other stimulants for my grades. And it's not so much what they think of me, right? Because I know I've never done it, and if they think I have, I mean, who cares? That doesn't really change anything. But what's more concerning and disheartening is that they don't think you can achieve certain results without doing it. And if you believe that, you will forever hold yourself back. As Henry Ford said, whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. These students are too focused on the short term and they think popping some pills are gonna help them in class, but they don't understand the long-term ramifications, how it's going to hold them back and crush them. They'll grow dependent. They won't be able to hone their study strategies in the same way as they could without it. And when medical school or residency starts, you think they can magically just stop and then get their shit in line? Probably not. Now, relying on a crutch is damaging for two reasons. First, you're limiting the natural challenges and development and growth that you would face. And then secondly, you're subconsciously telling yourself that you cannot do something without a crutch. And you'll never have the opportunity of really pushing yourself and seeing what you can accomplish without a crutch. And in doing so, you will discover your own limits and you'll push yourself and you will develop your own confidence. If there's one thing I want you to take from this video, it's this idea that you can learn anything, even how to learn. We often put ourselves in boxes, like I'm not athletic, or I'm not good at math, or I'm not organized. And then to behave in a way that contradicts that would result in cognitive dissonance. So you're less likely to ever get better at math or ever become more organized. You can do anything, you just can't do everything. You do have to prioritize your time and energy. Now, I have never had any formal business training, but I believe that I could learn. So I started Blue Link, a biomedical incubator at my medical school, and we secured funding. Then a couple years later, I quit residency and went all in on Medical Insiders, and that has grown and it's been quite successful. Until recently, I had never cycled more than 40 miles in a single ride, but I believed I could do 100. So I went to Salt Lake City with a friend. This wasn't even a sanctioned event. It was just him and I cycling. And you know, I did some research about fueling, etc., things to make it more likely to accomplish our goal. And that was that, we just did it. Now going back to stimulants, why have I never touched them? First of all, let me say I am not against responsible use of substances. I occasionally drink alcohol, although I will admit that the older I get, the less and less frequent it is. It's like once every few months, if that, at this point. But for stimulants, I mean, I don't have any medical condition requiring it. And if you do, again, that's a totally fine reason and this doesn't apply to you. But my friends weren't using it. It wasn't at the forefront of my mind. And to be frank, if I ever used stimulants for myself to get better grades, I would just see that as weak. And I don't want to be weak. If I'm the kind of person that doesn't have a medical condition to warrant the use of these substances, but I do because I think it's going to help me and I'm using it as a shortcut, I mean, that's soft. That means I don't have the discipline and the willpower to fix my life, to fix my study strategies, to fix my environment. I'm looking to shortcuts. And that's not the kind of person I want to be. I couldn't respect myself if I did. I mean, I think caffeine is fine. It's a much safer, milder drug, etc. But I still avoided it because I didn't want to be dependent on a substance. I wanted to be able to do things on my own. Why should I need to be reliant on something else? And during all of college and all of medical school, I literally drank coffee no more than once or twice per year. It was saved for those emergency situations where you're on overnight call, super sleep deprived, and like really needed something to help. But for the most part, it was like, just suck it up. Plus, I found out the hard way during my third year of medical school that caffeine, at least regular caffeine many times in a week, and IBD don't mix well. Now, one of the most valuable things you can do is building your own self-confidence, your own belief in yourself. And your self-esteem is an important part of that. It's your reputation you have with yourself. And I think that your reputation of yourself is more important than the reputation others have of you, in a way. I mean, they're both important, but at the end of the day, if you believe you can do something, that's what's gonna matter. For example, there is evidence that a competitor to Med School Insiders is bad-mouthing me and my company using these dirty tactics on SDN, on Reddit, but I refuse to ever stoop down to that level. I'm just gonna keep doing what I believe is right. I will keep trying to improve, keep trying to add value, and I just trust the process that the rest of it will take care of itself. If I am offering value to my viewers and to my customers, they're gonna share their experiences anyways, and that's gonna overpower any negative, dirty tactics. Look, I'm not the most successful guy in the world, so you should be taking everything I say with a grain of salt, but I am very proud with where I am at this point in my life, especially considering where I started, absolutely. And I attribute a great deal of that to building my confidence. You know, most MDs, after they graduate medical school, they have a very narrow idea of what they're qualified to do. Clinical practice, obviously, maybe write on a blog about being a doctor and doctor finances, or doing something else that's very, you know, specific to just medicine. But by pushing my own limits and taking these small risks and having these small wins and then these larger risks and then these larger wins, I didn't just know I could do anything I set my mind to, but I truly deeply believed it. And I think that's the secret sauce. That allows you to do things that yourself or other people told you was impossible. And the way I see it, this is probably the most effective and direct path in living a life on your own terms. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this video, you will also like my video on how productivity is not your problem. Much love, and I'll see you guys in that next one.